Hello, hi guys, my name is Sarvansh and thank you for watching my the other video about the SSCM tutorial. And in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a collection based on that direct membership rule and query rule include exclude collections. So let me start this video. So I am under SSCM asset and compliance. So I go into device and collections. So here I will show you first how you can manage your collections. So I am gonna create a one folder here, BLR, and I can create one more folder, DALI, like DAL. So that's how you can create your folders. Even if you want to create a subfolders, you can create subfolder as well inside that folders. So now here I am mentioning like IT. So under the BLR there is a department IT. Okay guys, so like that you can create your folders, subfolders, and now I'm gonna show you how you can create a collection. So here just click on collections, and here you can give it like I'm gonna show you direct membership rule collection. So you can give the any softwares, like you want to create a software for particular, create a collection for particular software. So suppose I'm Adobe Reader, and now here I'm gonna click is all systems. So limiting is something like from where you want to fetch your details. Okay, if it is not necessary, you can give all system. If you have any other master collection to your regions, so you can give it to give it that collection name here. Now okay, so I think this collection name is already used, so I can give like a Adobe Reader DC, so anything whatever you want. So here I'm gonna show you how you can add the machine as a direct rule. So click on the direct rule, go next, and here you can search it with the name. If you exactly remember, like the I do have test one, so here I can see the test one machine, and select it, next, and close. So if you want to add like a multiple machines at a time, you can use it your percentage as well. So percentage, test, and the percentage, so you will get all the machines related to test machines. So here is already added test 1 2 3 4. I'm gonna add it. So these are my the test machines. Okay guys, so now you can see in it. I'll just click another folder and create it here. It automatically refreshed. Okay, may it will take some time. So you can update the membership, right click and refresh it. So now you can see in it the four machines are there, still it is hanging. And I would like to show you one thing. If you are creating any direct membership rule connection and there is a no query inside, so guys don't select this, it's not required. It is required only for when you are creating a collection based on query rule include or exclude. So if you are gonna use it, or if you want to use it the mix up, you can schedule the update collection, because for direct membership rule no need to update it, it's like a hard coded. Okay, so now my the collection is ready. If you want to see it here, you can see machines are here, four machines. And another thing is, like if you don't want to add in this way, you can go your machine, search out, like I'm gonna give SSCM, search this, and suppose you want to add this machine to particular this collection, so you can just go here, add, and the existing collections. So it will give you the existing collection list, where it's my collection under Bangalore IT, and in this collection I want to add this machine. So in this way also you can add it the collections in you can add it the machine under the collection. So now it's became five. So there are the multiple ways waves. Even though you can add like a right click tool under your SSCM, so you can use it that. And if you want to add in direct membership tool, so you can go here and add it again under the properties, direct membership rule, direct rule, and you can follow the process what I shows you. So this is the one way, and another way I shows you, like you search the machine, right click and add to the existing machines. So that's how you can manage your direct membership rule collections. So now we are talking about the query based rule. So here is I'm gonna create it like all Windows 7. Here I can give all underscore Windows 7. Okay, so let me filter out how many Windows 7 I do have in my infra. IT, sorry, it's root all system. So I'm fetching data from the all systems. Here is, and here I'm gonna write a query. So it will be Windows 7. So if you have like a query ready, for the example, I create some queries to how you can do that. So you can copy paste as well, and even you can write it also yourself. So you can create yourself. I can show you the demo how you can create the query. So here you go, and here it select the system resource. Okay, and here what I'm gonna select it. What I have selected system one second, let me check it out again. What I'm gonna do it here SMS underscore system resource, and here I can take a operating system. SMS underscore client machines. Okay, resource name, and under the resource name here should be some operating system. Okay, so operating system name and version, here it is, like it's done. And here what you can keep, you have to select it your filtering also. Here is what we selected, it's a resource. No, what we have given, just let us check it out again. So it was the table. Okay, system resource. Here go to the criteria and select it system operating. No, let me check it here. Operating system name and the version. It should be. Why it is not coming? System resource. Showing criteria. Here is system. SYST is system. Resource system resource under system resource should be operating system. CKLM. Operating system version. Okay, yeah, finally I got it. So this is don't put it equal, it's put it like is like. And what is the for the Windows 7? Like you can mention it's Windows Workstation 7, Windows NT, put it this. Windows percentage, and it will be like we are getting for all machines. So let us get only the Windows. So here I will get all the Windows version. No, okay, it was for the Windows 7. So I can type it like a 6.1 something, it will come. Let me modify it again. So here will be, nothing is coming. Let us check the query. And here is like, okay, what I was writing here. Let me copy and paste, and I can do it for the Windows 7. So it will be 6.1. So the query, okay. Let's go with this. Nothing is coming. Why? What is the operating system? Microsoft Windows NT Workstation 6.01 only, Windows 7. Why it has to come? Okay, so now it's came. So I have Windows 7 two machines. It was taking some time to update that query. So I do have two machines for the Windows 7. So now let me create a Windows 10 machines. So I'm gonna here, and I want to filter it out all the Windows 10 machines. Go here and root all systems, click on next, and here go again on the query. Query will be like Windows 10, edit query, and you can just paste that query for the Windows 10. Easily you can get it, guys, from internet. Just I was trying to show you how you can create your own query. So if you started learning that, and just try it with that like a copy paste, and then try to understand that it's a WQL query. So it's not very tough to learn, easily you can learn it. And if you are struggling anything, you can just let me know, I will help you. So here is, I'm going under the Windows 10. So here is the machine is coming, test 2 and test 4. And Windows 7, it was coming test 3 and the test 1. So that's how you can create your based on that Windows version. And now just I wanna see it like for server 2K12, it's a version for the 6.3 NT server. So let me create a collection for the servers. This is servers 2K12, and here you can select it all systems, next, and again you give a query like I'm gonna create 2K12, and now click on next. No, I have not added. I can go and edit again. So here is query, and what I can give it like, no, I don't want the workstation, I want it like the server. So here I am giving servers, as we seen it here. What is the flavor for it? Just click on this. And what it's showing for the servers, it's the NT server. You can give the NT server or 6.3 also you can give it. So let me go and add it. Here it again. servers. So what it mentioned here under the query server 6.3. So 6.3 or anti servers also you can give anti servers or server, it's both are the same, but you need to put it percentage starting and end, so it will calculate starting word and the last word. So guys, here obviously you have to schedule it because we are using the collections query we are using, so it should be updated. If any of the servers machine added there, so automatically it will come to in your collection based on this running time. Click on next and now it's done. Close it and let's see how many machines came here. Let me update it, update the membership, and just refresh it again. So I have one machines. So in my infra in server 2k12, I do have one machine here. It will come now. Right, okay, so it's come. So I have 2k12 one machines, and that's how you can create your collection for Windows 7, 10, server 2k12. And if you want something other, so you can pause the video and read it, or I will paste it in my the description. So if you want any queries like the collection built version, like in the Windows 10, any built version you're gonna check it, or last hardware inventory, so which machines are last 30 days hardware inventory. So if you want to create it, I can show you the based on the hardware inventory as well. So go here and HW 30 days, and here you selected all machines. Go next, and this query is gonna help you to find out how many machines are not having the hardware inventory, like it's a greater than the 30 days. So if you want to filter it, you can write the query, and it's a very wide area to writing the query. It's up to you in what basis you want to write the queries. So it will collect that machines and it will give it to you. So you will come to know how many active machines are there in last 30 days and how many it's not there. So based on that, you can write your query. So now it's calculating, and let's see how many machines will be here in my the infra. Let me refresh also. So it's still it is calculating, and maybe I do have machines here or not, I'm not sure, because it's like 30 days I have given, so I don't have any machines. Let me go and reduce the time, because I am in lab, so maybe I will not get any machines more than 30 days. So I can check it, like I will modify it up to 5 days. Go here and just put it up to 5 days. So that will be good. At least I will get some few of the machines. Okay, so this is refreshing the data. Let it refresh, and okay, so these many machines are not active like 5 days. So they do have their hardware inventory more than 5 days. So you can filter it in the production at least for the 30 days. So you will be having the clear picture. Okay, in how many machines are there more than 30 days or 60 days or whatever your company parameters, or you wanna check it for the 1 week. So guys, I think hope you are clear with this about the collection and direct membership rule, and this for query based rule. So let me move it to the another things that is called like a include and exclude. So let me show you the scenario how you can create the include collection. So just I'm gonna do it like any software I can give, Chrome I can give. This time Chrome underscore include collection. So in this way, what can I do? I give in this, And if I want to add it in a direct membership rule, one machine, any of the machines, okay, let me add it first this, so you will be much and more clear. So test one I am adding. So first thing is I added normally one direct rule, and I have a requirement like few of the machines in a direct rule, and one of the collection it should be in a include collection. So let's go in the IT and I wanna include all Windows 7 machines. So let me go here and do this and do. So maybe it will not increase because my the test one machine is a Windows 7 and all the Windows 7 I added here. So let us test it. And how many machines I will get it? Chrome include. Update it. Okay, let me do the refresh. Only the one machine, update it. Let me check whether it's included or not. Okay, so it was not included, sorry. So let me include it, IT. And what was the old Windows 7 selected. And okay, now it's got included. So one machine was as a direct membership rule. Why I am showing you? So maybe you have a scenario where you want to include the direct membership rule as well and the include rule as well. So you can add it direct rule and then the include the other machine as well. So now I do have only two machines because one machine is a direct membership rule and the same machine the part of the another collection. So that's why it's a two count only. So let me add it here, include one more collection. That's I'm gonna do it for the Windows 10 and the BLR. And I do have like a Windows 10. So you can include any collection, whether that collection is a include based or exclude based. Sorry, include based or like a query based or the direct membership rule. So let me try this. I included two collections and how many? Now I do have like a four machines here. So why only the four machines? So in my Windows 7, it was two machines over test 1 and test 3. These are the Windows 7 machines and I do have the Windows 10 machines here. And so now 2 and 2, 4 machines. But I did the include direct membership rule as well here. But that machine is not showing because that machine is test 1 is matching what you include in your collection. So that's how you can do the your include, exclude collection and the direct membership rule. So let me go quickly for the another scenario. I am gonna like Chrome and I wanna show you exclude rule. So I want to exclude in my suppose I do have like all machines here and here is the Windows 7 and I wanna exclude only the machines is like Windows 10. I don't want Windows 10 machines. That my collection. Okay, so let me click next. Sorry, no, it's something goes wrong. Google Chrome exclude collection. So only the exclude it will not work. You gonna include something there. So I'm gonna include. First I have to use include, some machine should be there, all system. So I include first all system and in that all system I don't want to use Windows 7. So Windows 10, rest of the machines I wanna see it here and it will be like a combination than rest of the Windows 10 machines. So here will be my collection and here I have total machines, 5 machines. So 5 machines, it's a test 1, test 3, these are like my machines is like Windows 7 and 2 machines is unknown came because I put it a condition, take it from all system and remove Windows 10. So now it remove Windows 10 and I got it server 2K12 and this machine. So guys, like hope you are clear with that exclude collections. And the same way, if you want to add direct membership rule, include collection, exclude collection, you can do the everything in a same collection. And now here is, I'm gonna do it for what is that? It's like a MDM all systems, and I'm gonna use it a device category rule. So based on the devices, I create a laptop. I don't have the mobile devices to manage here. I need a ID to connect it. And then related to that ID, device automatically will reflect here. So you cannot see any devices under here. I can show you the query. It's automatically detected that query and where you can put it your the device ID. So go here and language, and here is my the MDM device category ID. So you can put it if you are gonna manage this MDM devices. So all the MDM devices automatically it will come to your collections. So that's how you can create your collection. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this video, and thank you, and keep watching, continue the videos. See you soon in my the next video.